Hello, WordPress developer and designer. So if you're looking to add a stylish horizontal scrolling effect to your WordPress website, which is built with Elementor, this video is for you. No matter you are an expert, no matter you are a newbie, you will learn how to add a stylish looking horizontal sliding effect for the sections within the pages, and it's gonna look awesome. So if you wanna learn how to add these cool stylish effect and animations on your website, make sure to watch the complete video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you want to keep learning more tips and tricks about Elementor and WordPress. So without further ado, let's get into the screen.
Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. Welcome back to another tutorial video. In this video, I'll show you how to make a horizontal scrolling page animation on your Elementor website using containers. We'll create this without using Elementor Pro or any extra plugin. So stay tuned, I'll tell you step by step how you can create this horizontal scrolling page. What I'll do is I'll start from scratch and I'll tell you each and every single point which I'll add in that page as well, so you guys can make exactly what I'm making. Okay, so I've added the page here. First of all, I'll click this plus sign in the screen, choose a Flexbox container. Okay. Let's add a background to it. Let's add some dark background. Okay, I'll make it some black color. Okay, and let's do some setting for this container as well. I want the content width from my left hand side to full width, and I want the min height to reach first, and we'll make it 100. Okay. Now you guys can see some padding here, so we'll go to advanced and remove the padding. Okay, done. Now let's add container here. I want two containers, so I'll add one and duplicate the other one. We'll choose the main container here and we'll change its direction to row so it looks like this. Now what I want is I wanted to add an animated headline in my first container, some text and a button. This is done. Now I'll sort it out and come back. I'll give it some styling, give some animated headlines, and we'll be back. Okay, now you guys can see that I've added this animated headline like this before text, the rotating text, and after text, and I've changed the style to rotating. Rest is all good. Okay, this is just a simple page which I've made. You guys can make it easily. Now I wanted to add an image widget here on my right side. Okay, let's add an image here. Okay, so let's add this image here. Okay, now in content, when I scroll down, I need to change. Okay, here you guys can see I open advanced here, and here you guys can see width. I need to change its width to custom and we'll make it 70. Okay, looks good. Now let's add two more images here within the container and let's add the image. Okay, and we'll change it content width to, we'll go to advanced, change its width to custom, and we'll make 26. Let's see why it's not working. We need to change the content to thumbnail. So now it's working. What else we can do is we need to go to style here and scroll down here. You guys can see the border. Let's add a border radius to each of our images. For this as well, let's add a border radius. I would go for 10. And now just add the third image which we want. Okay, below this. Okay, this is going to be my third image. We'll change, go to advanced again, change its width to custom. And I want this time the width to be 30. Again, let's go to style and scroll down. change the border to 10. Let's open Navigator so that we can easily select the images. So we have one container and we have three images within that container. First image we leave. For the second image, we'll go to its position. We'll change it to absolute and let's scroll down. Here you guys can see the offset values. We need to adjust. I'll make it 290 and minus 71. Let's see where it looks. So this is where it looks. And for this image, I want the position to be absolute as well. Okay, and let's scroll down. Let's change its offset value as well. 300, 257. Okay, now we'll select this container in which we have all the three images. So let's open Navigator and select it easily. Okay, this is done. Now we'll make align items to the center like this and see how it looks. Little bit is missing. To adjust the offset value to little bit, I think 75 looks cool. And for this as well, let's just do it. Looks pretty cool. Now you guys can see that my first page is ready. Have a look. This is how it looks. All we need to do is one more thing, which is a slight movement for all of our images. So for that, for the first image, I'll go to advanced, scroll down, and here you guys can see an option saying motion effect. We need to click that and we need to open this mouse effect and this 3D tilt as well. Okay, so when I click, this is how my image moves. Okay, we'll do the same thing for both these images as well. Okay, now you guys can see that it's working perfectly and just the way we want. We'll move towards the second container here. So first of all, I'll add a Flexbox container and I'll be adding this direction column here. Okay, so the content width needs to be full width, or maybe I can change it to auto here. So we can adjust it automatically, and widget, and we'll make it 100. Direction like this. I'll be adding another container within this container here, but maybe we need to change some padding here so that we don't get any extra gap. Okay, and for this container, okay, let me open Navigator so that I can easily select the containers here. Okay, so for this container, let's see if the padding is done. Okay, it's not done. Okay, this is done. Now for in this container here, which I have added, I'll go to style here and I'll insert an image here. Okay, this looks pretty cool. I'll add this image as my background image here. Now what I'll do is I'll add some animated headlines here. So from my left hand side, you need to search for an animated headline here. And what else do I want is an image widget. So let's add an image widget here. So I'll sort it out quickly. Okay, now you guys can see that I've added some headlines. I've given the shape circle. So you guys can see it's going to circle the mid part, which we want the text to be highlighted, some image here. So this container is done. Now I'll be adding another container here. You guys can see I'll be adding the Flexbox container. Okay, now for this container, what I have planned is adding a background image here. Okay. So let's add a color here. Let's add some greenish color here. Okay. This looks fine. Now let's give it some styling. First remove the padding here. Okay, and now go to layout and give it some styling here. Min height to width. And then we'll make it 100 so it covers the whole screen. We'll do the rest of the styling afterwards once we have done with it. Okay, so we need to add a heading here, and what else we can add is a text path. Okay, let's add a text path here. Okay, now for this container, I want my text to be aligned like this, and to be in the middle. Okay, let's add some heading here. Okay, so now you guys can see that I've added some text here and a text path here. Okay, we'll be doing rest of the changes afterwards. Okay, now I want the ending page for that. Okay, so I need to add a heading widget here and a button here. So let's add a heading and a button. Okay, and let's add a button here. I'll give it some background color. We'll go to style here from my left hand side. Choose the background type. I'll give it some black color here. And let's add the text and the button, and we'll do the same styling which we did before. That is, we'll go to layouts, change its width to content width to full width. Okay, and min height to width first, and then we'll make it 100. Okay, looks pretty cool. We'll align it in the center and we'll sort it out. Okay, now you guys can see it. I've added all the containers here, so you guys can see. We'll do the rest of the settings now. Okay, let's open navigator here so we can select the containers easily. Okay, for this container here, what we need to do is we need to go to advanced, and here you guys can see the option of size. You need to change it to grow. And for this container in which we have the animated headline and the image, just do the same thing. Change its size to grow, and for this container as well, let's change its size to grow. Go to advanced here from my left hand side, change its size to grow here. Okay, now what I'll do is I'll open the dashboard again here so that I can add a custom code here which will help me to horizontally scroll this page. Okay, when I go to Elementor here, I can see the custom code option. You need to click that option, add a new code here. I'll name it as horizontal scrolling page animation, and I'll paste the code here, which I'll also mention in the description below so that you guys can copy. Okay, so now I'll paste the code here like this. You guys can see. Now we'll click publish, and I'll choose a singular page here, and all singular, no, for a single page. And here I can type the name of my page. And let's just click update here. Okay, so we have added a code here, you guys can see. What else do we want is this. You need to add this container in this container here. So I'll copy and paste the container in this container, and I'll remove the remaining container here. So we have, you guys can see, two containers within this container. Okay, now you guys can see that What I want is I'll be adding a container here like this. Flexbox container here. Okay, and I'll change its content width to full width and min height to VH first. And then I'll make it 100 and let's change its padding to 0. Okay, so in this container, I'll be adding this container here, which we have added here. So let's just copy the containers and paste it in this container here. Okay, so I'll delete the other containers. Okay, now this is done. We need to, you guys can see we have two containers in it, one with the animated headline and one with the text path here. For this main container which we have added, we'll go to advanced from my left hand side and I'll add a CSS class here, mdw-horizontal-scroll. Let's click update here. Let's just add a CSS code here. Okay, so in this container in which we have both the containers here, we'll go to advanced and we'll add some custom CSS. Go to advanced, add some custom CSS class here. So code here, we'll paste the code which I'll also mention in the description below. Okay, let's click update. Now let me show you guys the final look of how my horizontal scroll animation looks. Okay, so you guys can see how it looks, the way animated headline is changing, and when you move, it moves horizontally and vertically both. So when we go back, it comes to its original position. It moves like this. Now it looks so beautiful. If you want to make it even more beautiful, you guys can add any other stuff you want. Okay, I hope you like this tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and comment below so that I can make more such videos for you. Thank you. Bye bye.